Hello, this is the part 2 of series lectures on numerical problem gas power cycle for IC engine. In this part we will solve problem based on the diesel cycle and objective of finding out the maximum temperature in the cycle, cutoff ratio of the cycle, temperature at the end of the isentropic expansion, that is the adiabatic expansion, net work done per kg of air during the cycle, thermal efficiency of the cycle, and the mean effective pressure of the cycle. So we will calculate these six parameter or values in two sessions, or each calculating each parameters in three batch. So now problem statement is this. The compression ratio is 15, which is here. You can see the compression ratio is V1 upon V2 is 15. This is given. Compression begin at 0.1 megapascal and 40 degree centigrade. That is the initial condition corresponding to the 0.1 in this cycle. Total heat added during the process 2 to 3. Which is constant process, constant pressure process in diesel cycle, which is 1.675 megajoule per kg of air. We have to find out the cutoff ratio, which is V3 upon V2. Temperature T3, the maximum temperature of the cycle. Maximum temperature of the cycles is corresponding to the 0.3. Always the maximum temperature of the cycle, which is when the heat is added and process of heat adding is completed. So this is the point T3 in auto as well as diesel cycle. Also T4, the temperature after the expansion process or adiabatic expansion process. This is adiabatic expansion process, and the T4 is the temperature after the expansion process. Now work done, efficiency, and mean effective pressure we have to find out. Also we have given constant CP, that is the molecular specific heat at constant pressure, molecular specific heat at the constant volume, universal gas constant, and gamma, which is CP upon CV, that is equals to 1.4 in this case of our medium. We assume that we are taking medium as a air. Suppose m is the number of kg moles of air which we are using here. So the m is the mass of air. How we calculate the kg mole? Mass of air in kg and molecular mass of the air. Molecular mass of 1 kg gas is 1. Mass of kg is 1 and the molecular mass of the air is 29. So the m kg mole of air is 1 upon 29 kg mole. Again, R is the 8.314 kilojoule, which is given. We converted it into the joule per kg mole, 8.31 multiplied by the 10 raised to the power 3. Also, T1 is given as a 40 degree centigrade, converting it to the degree Kelvin by adding the 273 to it, and it comes out to 313 degree Kelvin. Pressure is 0.1 megapixel, which is again converted to the 100 kilopascal. If we convert it to the 100 kilopascal. Now for an ideal gas, P1 V1 is equals to the MRT1 for any condition. Suppose at any condition of gas, that this relationship holds true for an ideal gas, and for point 1 where pressure is P1, volume is V1, temperature is T1, this relations states that P1 V1 equals to MRT1. Now we have P1, we have T1 in this gas, we have R1 and we have AM. So we can calculate the V1. So it comes out to be in such a way that V is equals to M upon RT1, and the V1 is given as a 8.93 meter. Now again, as you can see from here, after calculating the V1, the compression ratio is given so that we know that the V1 upon V2 or is equals to compression ratio. So V2 upon V1, that is the V2 upon V1 is the 1 upon compression ratio. Now V1 goes here, then V2 is equals to V1 into compression ratio, or V1 upon compression ratio is the V2. So we know the V1 from here, and compression ratio is given 15, this one. So it comes out to be, so V2 again, we have find out the V2, which is 0.06 meter cube per kg. Now we have P1, T1 and V1 here, and also we have V2. Now we will calculate the P2. Now as this is the process from 1 to 2, which is represented by 1 to 2 on this diagram, is a process of adiabatic type, that is the isentropic or adiabatic compression. So for this adiabatic compression, this equation holds true, that is the P2 upon P1, that is the P2 upon P1 equals to V1 upon V2, V1 upon V2 raised to the power gamma, which is 1.4, that is the ratio of Cp upon Cv, so 1.4 for air. Now by this we can calculate, by this equation we can calculate P2 equals to, P1 goes here, and again you can see the V1 upon V2 is the compression ratio. So compression ratio to the power gamma multiplied by P1, and the compression ratio is given, and P1 is also given to us, and thus we can calculate the P2. So now we have in this cycle the major parameters on important points of or prominent points of this cycle is 1, 2 is P, V and T here. We have all P, V, T values here. We have P2 and V2 here. Now take again adiabatic process from 1 to 2 to calculate the T2. Again, this equation holds true for adiabatic process. T2 upon T1, that is the T2 upon T1 is equals to V1 upon V2, again the CR, compression ratio, power gamma minus 1. So again T1 comes here and T2 comes out to be this value. And T1 is given 313, and compression ratio is 15, and 1.4 minus 1 is the point 0.4, and this comes out to be 924. Now we will find the T3. So there is two method of finding out the T3. As this is a constant pressure process, so we can find out the temperature T3 by the relationship of the volume and the temperature, relationship between the volume and temperature on the for the process of constant pressure. This is T3 upon T2 is equals to V3 upon V2, but we don't know the V3 here. We know the V2, but we don't know the V3, so it is not possible to get out the value of T3 from this relationship. Now second method is that we can use, as we know the heat added, so second method is taking the heat added method to calculate the T3. As the heat, how we calculate this, let's see it. Q in, that is the heat added, is 1.675 megajoule, which is 1675 kilojoule if we convert it to kilojoule. And also we know the heat addition at constant pressure is the specific heat at constant pressure multiplied by the temperature difference of the end conditions of the process, the final initial and the final condition, difference between the initial and final condition of the temperature multiplied by the specific heat for the constant pressure. This is the heat addition at constant pressure, and if we have heat addition or heat rejection at this process 4 to 1, which is constant volume or constant volume process, this expression is Cv multiplied by the temperature difference. So in this process, the temperature difference corresponding to the point T3 and T2 is T3 minus T2, and process is constant, so multiplied by the Cp is the heat transaction, and this is the here heat transaction is heat adding. So heat addition is given to us, which is this one. Cp we know. Now T2, as we calculated from here, so T3 is very easy to calculate out. So now putting the value of Cp, T2, the T3 is very easy to calculate, and it comes out to be, this goes down here and this goes here plus, and T3 comes out to be 2591.33 degree Kelvin. So now we have P1, V1, T1, also P2, V2 and T2, and now we have also the T3 and also P3, because P3 is equals to the P2. So the first answer comes out from our problem is the maximum temperature, which is the T3 of the cycle, is the 2591. So now final conditions of different properties of the cycle at prominent points of the cycle are P1, V1 and T1 is known to us, P2, V2 and T2 is also known to us, and T3 is known to us, and P2 is also known to us. Now we will calculate now the V3, because we want to calculate now the cutoff ratio. Cutoff ratio is the V3 and ratio of the V2. Now for constant pressure process, that is the 2 to 3, as we know the P2 is equals to P3. Now we know for an ideal gas, P1 V1 upon T1 is equals to constant, or for points 2 and 3 here in the ideal gas relationship will be P2 V2 upon T2 for point 2 and 3, and P3 V3 upon T3, both are equal because both are equal to the constant. Now as we know the P2 equals to P3, so P2 and P3 is cancelled out to each other, and T3 grows here, then it comes out to be V3 is equals to T3 multiplied by V2 upon T2. Now V2 is given from here, we know the V2. T2 again we have calculated recently. T3, which is also available now, maximum temperature of the cycle with us. So V3 comes out to 0.168 meter cube per kg. So now we also have P, V and T for this 0.3. Now we will calculate the cutoff ratio. So what is the cutoff ratio? Cutoff ratio is the V3 upon V2. Now we have V3, which is 0.168, and V2 0.06, which is already with us from previous calculation. So now cutoff ratio is 2.8. So this is our second answer. The cutoff ratio of cycle is 2.8. Now we will calculate the T4, that is the temperature after the isentropic expansion, which is our third answer for this session and the last one. Now take again the adiabatic or isentropic process from 3 to 4. Now in this case, take the process 3 to 4, which is expansion adiabatically. Again, this relationship holds true for an adiabatic process, that is the T4 upon T3, V3 upon V3, raised to the power. gamma minus 1. Here again, T3 is known to us, very easily highest temperature of the cycle, V3 and V4. Now you can see the V4 is equals to V1. V4 is equals to V1, which is again 0.898. So V4 is equals to V1, so V3 upon V1. So V3 is, we have just calculated the V3, this one. So all values are known to us, excepting the T4, and T4 we can find out from this relationship. T3 will go here and comes out T4 is this. Now putting all these values in this, this comes out to be T4 is 1325.37. So thank you. This is all for this session. We have calculated all the three values, which is the cutoff ratio, which is the highest temperature, and the temperature after the expansion of hydrogen. We will continue in next session and calculate the work done per kg of air, cyclic efficiency, and mean effective of the